Hello and welcome to FDT Chats, where we sit down and talk to some of the great and the good of fintech for a bit of a chat. I'm Liz Lumley, and joining me today is Eugene Pradasenia of Armada Labs. How are you?
Doing great, Liz. What about yourself?
Very, very good. We're having a bit of Florida weather here over in the UK. It's about 85 degrees Fahrenheit. So, you know, we can't really go anywhere, but, you know, we'll get to that.
Yeah, I always joke in saying, like, you know, British people, they always complain about weather because you don't want tourists to come, right? But every time I visit Britain, like, you know, I love the weather and beautiful outdoors.
I know, it's great. So we're going to start off with a question I ask everybody, which is, who are you and what do you do?
Armada Labs is a professional services company, servicing fintechs, first and foremost. Co-founded company about 20 years ago, so we've been around the block for quite some time. But at the same time, what it brings, what value does it bring to our clients is that not only that we creating a great products and supporting fintechs, over the last 20 years, we built several spin-offs of Armada Labs, like as a separate businesses, like, you know, SaaS platforms and other great products, made a couple of exits, successful exits, which like to say, like, you know, we bring this free consultative hat together in the relationship with the fintechs, and that makes the ultimate product much better than anticipated by the clients. So they get in free consulting together with the great services.
Yeah, so I mean, you really work with putting together sort of custom built solutions for some of your clients or for all of your clients. You know, what are some of the reasons for firms going with a custom built solution as opposed to maybe something a bit more off the shelf?
Well, I mean, like, it depends on the situation of their, like, you know, use case. If you take a specific case, sometimes, like, you know, off-the-shelf product works great for the client transformation. But in case of custom solutions, because we build it so many products in different sub-verticals over the years, we've seen the trend that with their quick spin-off of the cloud technologies, with the big transformations that happening, like, you know, used to be like in a decade, right now it's like shrinking big time. So transformations could happen and required sometimes driven by the market to be done with under the year project. So it pushes the clients to demanding from companies, from the like, you know, outcomes, like much quicker solutions. And with, don't get me wrong, like, you know, we build great custom products, like, you know, from the ground zero, when it involves, like, you know, all the complex things, but it takes time. So, like, things don't happen overnight. But what we've seen over the last years, big transformation in the quick demand. Nobody wants to wait, right? So they want to wait. At the same time, sometimes off-the-shelf product doesn't fit and satisfy all the needs. So what we've done, and that works great. We've seen a tremendous, like, you know, outcome. We developed a hybrid model, where because we built so many systems and products before, we build what we call like building blocks, call it like pieces of Lego, that allows us to innovate much faster, save like 6 to 8 months from initial development, like, you know, we're saving. At the same time, clients are not getting off-the-shelf product. We customize them just to completely satisfy their vision and pose them to their future transformation and changes that are going to happen to be adaptive and much quicker. Why? Because, like, you know, modular approach allows them to concentrate on individual adjustments, quick time to market delivery, see how it works, which becomes extremely important. And again, a lot of people saying because of the COVID-19, like, you know, it drives, like, you know, some transformation. But even in a normal economy, call it, like, you know, before the pandemic events, that brings tremendous value to our clients. And that's what we've seen, market is moving, and our clients are loving this hybrid approach versus just a pure custom development.
That makes a lot of sense. I mean, I was looking on your website, and a lot of your clients seem to be focused a lot in the SME space, and also sort of people who have been underserved by the banking market, which you know, I would argue, and a lot of people would argue, the SMEs are in that bucket of being underserved by traditional banks. Is that, was that more by design, or how did that happen that so many of those clients were in that space for you guys?
Well, I mean, as you know, historically, like back, if we unwind like a decade ago, like, you know, when it was a financial crisis, banks failed to deliver results. And again, fintechs came out and they became a part of ecosystem. They earned the spot. And obviously, like, you know, SMEs, I mean, small businesses, like, you know, they're always hungry for the capital, right? Mm-hmm. It becomes kind of huge demand. Like, nobody wants to wait. Nobody wants to wait for 2 months, 3 months to be approved. Mm-hmm. And sometimes it's a matter of life or death for them. Like, you know, access to the capital would actually create it, like, you know, supply of the chain, that a lot of companies start looking in this aspect. On the served population, on the banking, that's, I guess, becoming, it's always been a trend over the last decade, but recent events also dictating inclusion, you know, like, to be really important part of the strategy for fintechs that are looking to be engaged in this market. It creates like ability for them to win the client, will create like a consumer loyalty, right? You know, loyal customers. And definitely a lot of companies have been looking in this arena. So like, I could say it's been a part of the strategy, but at the same time, you know, like, market was helping us to dictate, like, you know, where to focus and where to deliver the great results for the companies.
Yeah, I mean, since you mentioned focus, it sort of leads me to my next question. And of mm-hmm. course, you know, almost every interview we talk about right now mentions the global pandemic and COVID-19. You know, what are some of the sort of trends that you've been seeing that have come into sharp focus, you know, amidst of the global pandemic we're going through right now?
Well, again, like, I wish I could give you the straight answer, meaning that, like, tell you give you predictions, like, what we're going to look like 6 months down the road, a year. Yes, nobody, first of all, predicted this outcome. At the same time, we like to look at this from optimistic standpoint at Armada, meaning though, like, you know, sometimes crisis and challenges bring great opportunities, and especially for our clients. So, like, from, yes, we've seen some, like, you know, things that been slow down with some of the clients, but majority of them continue roadmap and approach, especially, like, you know, if we're talking about being technology, important part of any fintech, and when the system is built in a modular approach, like pieces of Lego, like to say, mm-hmm. it allows them to kind of tweak things, change the strategy, to be adaptive, to be understandable to the client's needs, to client's hurts, like, you know, like, if we're talking about consumer lending or business lending, right? And how to adopt this Brindos game plan for the front end business through the technology definitely helps our clients to sustain through this pain. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, I definitely want to say that we are going to see a different landscape moving forward, good or bad, but things are not going to be the same. And we taking this as a given fact. So we have to kind of live with this. But at the same time, it will push, because, like, you know, one of the things, like, you know, I've been reading a lot of articles and research papers, people say that we are ready in year 2030. So we already this jump leap because of the consumer behavior has changed, the landscape of the outcomes for the business lending, and clients have, I'm talking about clients of fintechs, they have to adopt. I mean, they have mm-hmm. to listen to the new realities. They have to build this consumer stickiness either by applying different technologies. They have to find a way to mitigate their risk, but include, if we're talking about SMEs, like a small business lenders, when they're going to come out and 2 months later, 3 months later, they will be needing the much needed capital to sustain mm-hmm. their business to move on. So that's definitely affecting their how the providers and ecosystem companies like Armada and others are servicing clients and what approaches we're suggesting to them.
Yeah, I know that. I mean, so many in this industry have been talking about disruption for so long. It's, you know, now this is what disruption looks like. Yeah, you've got a very hard lesson for a lot of people going on right now.
Yeah, yeah.
So I wanted to talk a little bit about, so you guys are based, headquartered in Florida. Yep. And I always like talking to fintechs that are not in sort of the traditional financial capitals like Singapore, London, New York, you know, find, mm-hmm. you know, financial services happens all over the globe. So maybe to put like a positive spin on it, what do you think some of the advantages you get from being based in Florida as opposed to a more traditional financial hub?
Well, beautiful sunshine. Well,
I said outside the weather.
Well, on a serious note, like, yes, like, you know, as innovation happens, like, you know, development of the clouds and us being involved on their cloud-based projects and communicating with our clients globally while we are located in one spot, definitely it doesn't put us in disadvantageous position. I mean, it helps us to some extent with their talent acquisition, you know, because we have like seen like less competition from the typical, you know, like hotspots for the fintechs. Mm-hmm. At the same time, you know, like our research and development center is located in Europe, right? Mm-hmm. And basically, we don't see any disadvantages, only like, you know, because like, you know, clients nowadays, they don't really like, you know, per se, like, you know, not care, but like, you know, they're not so concerned about where you're located. You don't have to be, you know, a few, you know, like subway stops away from them, like to show up in the office. So, you know, like as long as we bring the great value, like it works just fine wherever you're located.
Yeah, no, I think that trend was happening for quite a while. But I mean, now we're, you know, in an environment where you're located for a lot of companies doesn't matter, which is probably a good thing. Yeah. So moving on, I think you've answered a lot of questions about how, you know, the environment we're in right now is affecting work and a lot of trends. So I wanted to end our chat really talking about, you know, how you're dealing with the global pandemic personally. You know, how are you coping, if you wanted to share that a bit?
Well, I'm not going to be unique by admitting that we as a parents, like as a lot of parents, became like gurus, and our kids are becoming like, you know, Zoom specialists, right? So you have to find the balance between, you know, like spending a lot of time in isolation, like, you know, with their family, which again, to some extent, helped a lot, like, you know, to realize like how much time we were missing away from the family when we consumed by the business needs and everything. But overall, like, you know, as a family, like, you know, went through the different stages of acknowledgement of the issue, like, you know, coping with this, like, you know, finding the way to fill the daily routine with some other things that would make us stronger to come out from this. And that's when we talk about on the personal level. On the company level, again, like, you know, this COVID-19 was not planned in our, you know, like company's agenda.
I don't know, it's either.
But at the same time, like, you know, being, you know, like remote, used to work with the multiple locations globally, supporting clients ranging from Australia and New Zealand to North America and Europe, it definitely taught us before, like, you know, how to work effectively and being there for our clients. So on the clients, like, you know, like matter, our clients don't see a difference in providing all the services. We've been kind of with a switch, being able to work remotely, like, you know, completely from our offices or from homes. And that works, continues to be, as long as we're providing services to the clients and finding the way internally to be effective. I mean, we should not see a difference. Obviously, we're missing, like, you know, a lot of face-to-face interaction when you human touch. As you see, like, you know, FTT, like, is going digital. So, like, it's going to be interesting to see how can we maintain this lovely interaction while still, like, you know, 1,000 miles away, right?
Yeah, we're big on that. Yeah, we're working hard on that.
So other than that, like, you know, life goes on. And I like to tell to our clients or employees, let's think optimistically. So, like, we're going to come out from this with much stronger approach. And there are going to be new challenges, like, you know, moving forward. There are going to be new crisis coming abroad. As long as we think optimistically and work hard, so, like, to find those ways, as I mentioned, like, you know, building consumer stickiness, like, you know, loyalty of the customers, and I'm talking about of our clients. Same thing, like, you know, being innovative and inclusive. Like, you know, that's becoming an important part of the world today. So, like, you know, we're all going to be continuing our innovation and supporting each other through the process.
No, Eugene, I agree completely. And I might be trying to hire your children to teach my parents how to use Zoom, which has been pretty difficult.
Well, I'm afraid, like, you know, if innovation continues this way, like, you know, a few years later, like, you know, they're going to be teaching us, our kids, right, how to learn things.
Yeah. Great. Eugene, thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Thanks for having me. And we'll see you digitally around in a couple of weeks.
Bye-bye.
Thanks. Bye-bye.